It's the 27th of April 2018. Welcome to Bitcoin News Today. Let's have a quick look at the charts before we go to the news headlines. So this was the peak. Remember that the Bitcoin price did suddenly increase from the 24th of April, and it peaked on the 25th of April, but then we did see a decline in price. And again, on the 26th of April, yesterday, it did start to go up again. So I'll come back to the chart after these news headlines. So first of all, we've got a headline from The Independent. Bitcoin will replace gold and soar in price to $700,000, says a major investor. This comes from John Pfeffer, a partner at Pfeffer Capital. So that's come up in the news again. It's not a new article, but we did see this about a week ago. So more positive news there. The next article, Mt. Gox moves 16,000 Bitcoin and 16,000 Bitcoin Cash coins out of its wallet. And this is to do with the now defunct Mt. Gox exchange, which is selling off some of its funds, I believe, to pay their debts. And this has been uncovered by looking at their Bitcoin wallets. So some people are saying that this is negative. It could possibly mean that the Bitcoin price will come down. But you know, we've got to wait and see on this story. It's not positive or negative, in my opinion. So on to the next story. And by the way, please do let me know in the comments if you like these videos. Let me know what you would like to see more of. Do you want to see more of the news, or do you want to see more of the technical analysis? And just about me, I've been trading Bitcoin now for over 3 years. So I've been looking at these charts for quite a while, but only really got into making videos about Bitcoin quite recently, with the latest surge in Bitcoin popularity that started in November and December last year. So please do let me know what you like about the videos. Subscribe if you want more videos like this, and do give the video a thumbs up, please. I really appreciate that. So last but not least, actually, second to last headline, and then we'll go on to the chart analysis. So Bitcoin price, CoinDesk boss says Bitcoin likely to remain strongest player in crypto. I agree with this because it does have the highest market cap out of all of the cryptocurrencies, and it was the first, and it's the one that all cryptos are basically based on. So yeah, definitely do I'd recommend that you do keep your footing with the Bitcoin, but also consider trading the other coins as well, because the percentage gains can be higher on the other coins because the costs per coin are lower. Okay, so we come on to the Express now. Bitcoin price live, crypto experts optimistic over George Soros's entry as futures soar. Now this is an interesting article. I had to check this out myself. So it only come out today, and they are saying that futures trading is particularly high. And if we actually check this, we can check this on the Bitcoin shorts chart. Indeed, it did go high at the beginning of April, but it has dropped off considerably. So when you check the news, take it with a pinch of salt, because often journalists are way behind, and that's why I do a lot of technical analysis. So onto the charts now. So we are seeing that there is a recovery happening that started with this massive lightsaber-like candle that started at 9 p.m. British Summer Time on the 26th of April, which was yesterday, if you're watching this video today, on the 27th of April. And then we did see it going up, and what we're seeing on the RSI is that it has gone up but then started to level off. Then it did edge up a little bit and it's come down a little, so I don't know if it's going to carry on at that level or if we might see another surge in price. Hopefully there is going to be a surge. If we look at the RSI, we can see that it has not reached a oversold level at the moment. It is higher than average, but it's not gone into the oversold zone, which I class as a RSI of over 70. So there is room for the price to go higher. I don't know if that's going to happen in the short term or if we're going to have to wait a little bit. So you can start taking profits around this level here, which is at $9,363. And hopefully we are going to go back up to the levels of $9,688 or higher. Hopefully this trend will resume that we did see earlier. If we go to the 1 day chart, I'll just show you quickly what I mean by that, because we did see that it bottomed out at 6,561, and then we've seen a trend that is going upwards, so hopefully that trend is going to continue up, because as I say, we've not reached oversold levels on the RSI. And on the 1 day chart, it does look like the MACD is still on the way up, although it is very high at 364. Let's see if we've reached those levels before. Yes, in fact we did. It reached massive 2400. That was at the end of December when we did see the record high. So there's room for it to go further up. It just really depends on lots of things, so many things that can affect the price. But yep, hopefully it's going to go up higher. We are entering the territory now, or nearly entering the territory, where I would suggest taking profits. Remember, this is not financial advice. I do hope that my videos help you to make profits, but always do your own research, and don't invest money in Bitcoin that you can't afford to lose. So let me know what you think in the comments, please. Please do let me know what you like about these videos, what you don't like, and hopefully I can make them better in the future. I hope that my videos are hype free. I don't promote any paid memberships or anything like that that you might see in other people's videos. And my videos are ad free, which I hope you appreciate. I'm not being paid by YouTube to make these videos. If you're new to Bitcoin and you want to get started, then do click the link in the video description and you can get $10 worth of Bitcoin free through the exchange that I use, Coinbase, which is a very trusted exchange. It's not the top exchange. You'll notice I use Bitfinex here, and that's purely because Bitfinex is the top exchange. It's the most used, therefore it's got the most data available, so it's very good for chart analysis. But I do prefer, well, I do use Coinbase myself. I've never used Bitfinex. I think Coinbase is easier. So yeah, I look forward to hearing from you in the comments. I look forward to seeing that thumbs up, and I look forward to you subscribing as well. So thank you very much for watching. I shall see you again tomorrow. Until then, bye for now.